of LeBron James. Before Steph Curry. And before Isaiah Thomas. There was Pittsburgh's own Chuck Cooper, my grandfather, out of Duquesne University.
My father was a great ball player, and he opened the door for so many to follow. He was a very modest guy. He wasn't going to go around and say, I'm Chuck Cooper, the first African-American drafted in the NBA.
Before Earl Loy became the first black player to play in an NBA game in 1950, or Nat Sweetwater Clifton became the first black player to own an NBA contract the same year, there was Chuck Cooper, the first African-American to be drafted when he was chosen by the Boston Celtics in the second round of the 1950 NBA draft.
He was immediate starter, immediately made contribution. He was one of their key players that really helped turning that franchise around.
And a sensational show by Charlie Cooper as Boston wins it 80-74.
Playing alongside Hall of Famers Bob Cousy and Ed McCauley, Cooper averaged almost 7 points and 6 rebounds per game during a 7-year NBA career that was also hampered by racism on and off the court.
What it was like for my father playing professionally in 1950 segregated America, it was tough. Especially when they traveled down south. My father had a great relationship with Bob Cousy. There was a time when they were in North Carolina, one of those times where my dad couldn't stay at the hotel with the team. And he decided to take a train back to Boston. And his good friend and his roommate, Bob Cousy, decided to take that train with him.
Despite earning All-American honors as a celebrated basketball player for an integrated program at Duquesne University, Cooper endured racism, especially while playing against schools from the South.
Anytime you deny something because of the color of your skin is tough. It's probably harder for Chuck Cooper, because Chuck was from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Well, in 1946, the University of Tennessee came to Pittsburgh to play Duquesne. And, you know, they said if Chuck Cooper's allowed to play, they won't participate. And Duquesne took a team vote, and it came back unanimous that if my father couldn't play, they would send the University of Tennessee home without a game. And that's exactly what they did. You have to really give his college teammates a lot of credit when they took that stand against the University of Tennessee.
1 year later, Jackie Robinson changed the sports world forever when he integrated baseball.
Out, Jackie Robinson slams a triple to left center.
Chuck Cooper belongs in the Hall of Fame the way Jackie Robinson did, the way all the people who were, you know, definitely pioneers in their particular sport. He didn't have 25 years to tell his story or to celebrate or to be celebrated.
Chuck Cooper died in 1984. He was 57 years old.
I think one of the great things is that his son and his family have worked so hard to see his story survive.
And on behalf of the Boston Celtics, Mr. Auerbach, Mr. Cousy, and Mr. Russell will present the Cooper family with a piece of the famed parquet floor along with a replica Chuck Cooper jersey.
In 2003, Earl Loy became one of the first of the NBA's early African-American pioneers inducted into the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame, followed by Sweetwater Clifton in 2014. But as the years went by, Chuck Cooper continued to be passed over for the honor. But on Friday, September 6th, 69 years after breaking the NBA's color barrier with Lloyd and Clifton, Chuck Cooper will finally join his fellow pioneers in the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame.
Cooper takes the pass and drops in a perfect two-pointer.
I hope my father's remembered in basketball circles as a pioneer. Someone who opened the door.
Well, it's quite a group here. Presenting Chuck Cooper for enshrinement are Bill Russell, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Ray Allen, Elgin Baylor, Larry Bird, Julius Erving, Tommy Heinsohn, Manny Jackson, Isaiah Thomas, and Dominique Wilkins. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Chuck Cooper is Chuck Cooper III. Hold your applause for a minute, because I don't want to miss this opportunity to take this little picture. Just kind of get this out of the way. You can't get this group. You can't get this group like this over here too much. And then we get this one over here before we get going. Eat your heart out, all y'all. There we go. All right. Congratulations once again to the family of Chuck Cooper.